Now, rape-accused Bishop Franco Mulakal will be questioned by the Kerala police at the Thiruvananthapuram Crime Branch office in Ernakulam. The Kerala police have made massive arrangements in Kottayam district for the questioning of the bishop accused of raping a nun multiple times. Meanwhile, Bishop Mulakal moved to Kerala High Court on Tuesday seeking anticipatory bail. The matter has been posted for hearing on September 25th. Meanwhile, nuns continue to protest against the bishop and demand his immediate arrest.
അവര് വീണ്ടും സമയം നീട്ടിക്കൊടുക്കുകയാണ് കുറ്റവാളിക്ക്. അപ്പൊ കുറ്റവാളി ഇങ്ങനെ പുറത്തു നിൽക്കുന്തോറും തെളിവുകളെല്ലാം നശിപ്പിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കും. ബിഷപ്പ് ഫ്രാങ്കോയും അവരുടെ കൂട്ടാളികളും സമീപിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ്. അങ്ങനെ ഓരോ കാര്യങ്ങളും ഞങ്ങൾക്കെതിരെ പ്രകോപിപ്പിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യുകയാണ്.
We have faith in the court, but we have no faith in the government. He is suffering now again and again. Why the government, the people's representative, they are keeping quiet about it?
Bishop arrest cheyathathollam kaalam kooduthal telivukal nashippikkappettondirikkukayanu. Aa nashippikkunna anusarichu njangalude jeevanum adu pole thanne apakadathilekku pogiyanu cheynathu. Adukondaanu nammal oru ingane oru aavashyam nammal munnottu vekkunnathu.
Let me go across to my colleague Manjeet Sehgal, who is joining us from Jalandhar, and also Shalini, who is in fact in Kottayam, getting us all the latest developments from there. Coming to you first, Manjeet, today is the day when the bishop was supposed to present himself in front of the authorities. He's still in Jalandhar. What's the plan? When is he expected to leave?
Well, Ankit, Franco Bishop Mulakal has already left Jalandhar, so he is not here. He was served a Kerala police notice on Saturday by the local police through the SHO, which was received by Franco Mulakal personally, and he has already left to appear before the police team, which will be questioning him second time. Remember, he is being questioned to clear some contradictions. Contradictions were also found in the statements given by the rape survivor, by Franco Mulakal, in his earlier questioning and also in the witnesses. So police will be clearing all these contradictions in the questioning, which will take place during the day. And meanwhile, Franco Mulakal has moved the Kerala High Court yesterday, saying that the allegations leveled against him were concocted or cooked by the nun who are seeking vengeance against the action which he took against her after receiving several complaints, and one of the complaints was that she was having an illicit relationship with her close relatives. So police will be grilling Franco Mulakal today, and while as you said, court has already said that sought a report from the state government on his anticipatory bail, and in another case in which his arrest has been demanded, hearing will take place on 24th of September. So his questioning will take place today, and this is a big day for the nun.
Okay, thank you, Manjeet, for joining us with all those details. Let me also bring in Shalini at this point of time. Shalini, today would of course be an important day as far as this case is concerned. So far, the allegations in the Kerala police has been that they have given a long rope to the bishop. It's been more than 80 days. No arrest, custodial, you know, questioning possibly will take place today. Are there chances? What are your sources telling you of this bishop being arrested?
Well, Ankit, it's been almost 85 days, you know, since the FIR was first filed and this nun-leveled rape charges. And the 12th day of protest outside the Kerala High Court, which these nuns have been coming from Kottayam, sitting there on protest and going back. Now, the interrogation is happening in Thiruppunithara in the Ernakulam district. That is where Bishop Franco is expected to reach by 10 a.m., where DYSP Subhash will be meeting him there, the investigating officer, and they'll take him into interrogation. Now, for how long will this interrogation last? This interrogation will last for as long as Franco's health sustains him to sit inside there with the investigation officers, is what our sources in the police tell us. Now, will there be an arrest likely? Ankit, unfortunately, that seems a little unlikely because of the bail application that was moved yesterday. However, since the court has not put a no arrest order out in this particular case, if the police want, they can arrest Bishop Franco Mulakal if they have a strong case against him. What the police police has said that he's being called because there are contradictions in the victim statement, in the rape survivor statement, and in the accused statement, and they need to iron out these contradictions. And since this case is 2 years old, they're finding it difficult to do that. But the Kerala police, after facing much flack in this case for not taking any action, for not arresting the accused till now and taking him into custody, they might have to resort to arresting Bishop Franco. The government, on the other hand, has also been mum, with no one coming out in support of the nuns who are sitting out here. It's only the former chief minister, V.S. Achyudanand, who called up the family of the complainant nun, telling them that justice in its due course will convict the criminal. But apart from that, no word from the government yet, Ankit.
All right. Thank you so much, Shalini, for joining us with all those details. We will come back to you for more on this story. Meanwhile, the rape accused Bishop Franco Mulakal has filed an anticipatory bail before the Kerala High Court. This comes a day before he is to appear before the Kerala police. While the nuns have been demanding the arrest, the church has still not sacked the accused bishop. More details in this report.
Bishop Franco Mulakal, accused of rape, seeking protection from arrest from the Kerala High Court. A day before he was to appear before the Kerala police for questioning, the bishop came out all guns blazing against the complainant nun, accusing her of wreaking vengeance as a part of an afterthought of a vicious program. This even as the protest by the nuns in Kochi entered its 11th day. Scores, including the complainant's sister, sat on hunger strike, demanding that the bishop step down.
അവര് വീണ്ടും സമയം നീട്ടി കൊടുക്കുകയാണ് കുറ്റവാളിക്ക്. അപ്പോൾ കുറ്റവാളി ഇങ്ങനെ പുറത്തു നിൽക്കുന്തോറും തെളിവുകളെല്ലാം നശിപ്പിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കും. ബിഷപ്പ് ഫ്രാങ്കോയും അവരുടെ കൂട്ടാളികളും സമീപിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ്. അങ്ങനെ ഓരോ കാര്യങ്ങളും ഞങ്ങൾക്കെതിരെ പ്രകോപിപ്പിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യുക. നമുക്ക് തോന്നുന്ന ബിഷപ്പിനെ തന്നെയാണ് സപ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. അതുകൊണ്ടാണല്ലോ ഇത്രയും ദിവസമായിട്ട്, 85 ദിവസമായിട്ട് നമുക്ക് നീതി കിട്ടാത്തത്. അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഇവർക്ക് എന്നേ നീതി, എന്തെല്ലാം തെളിവുകളുണ്ടായിട്ടും അവർ നീതി തരുന്നില്ല. അപ്പോൾ പൂർണ്ണമായിട്ടും അവരിപ്പോഴും ബിഷപ്പ് ഫ്രാങ്കോയുടെ ഭാഗത്ത് തന്നെയാണ്.
ബിഷപ്പിനെ അറസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യാത്തിടത്തോളം കാലം കൂടുതൽ തെളിവുകൾ നശിപ്പിക്കപ്പെട്ടുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ്. അത് നശിപ്പിക്കുന്നതനുസരിച്ച് ഞങ്ങളുടെ ജീവനും അതുപോലെ തന്നെ അപകടത്തിലേക്ക് പോവുകയാണ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് നമ്മൾ ഒരു ഇങ്ങനെയൊരു ആവശ്യം നമ്മൾ മുന്നോട്ട് വെക്കുന്നത്.
The bishop stands accused of grave crimes. First, through his proxies, and now in his bail plea. He continues to discredit the complainant nun. But what gives him the long rope to be able to do so? Why hasn't he been asked to step down? Won't his position allow him to influence the probe? With Shalini and Gopi in Kochi, Bureau Report, India Today.
And this is our top focus on the burning question, and we are asking on India Today a few important questions, because the fact still remains that the bishop, despite his offer to resign, is he now trying to influence the probe by other means? Because in his bail plea as well, he couldn't help resort to maligning the victim, to in fact victim shaming. That seems to be the primary defense as far as this bishop is concerned. So what we are asking today on the burning question. Question number one, in fact, is this offer to resign a face saver? And what is this offer to resign? Why hasn't the church sacked this bishop in the meanwhile? Question number two that we are asking on India Today, despite outrage, victim shaming still on. Remember, in his anticipatory bail plea, in fact, Franco Mulakal once again attacked the nun who has accused him of rape. Question number three that we are asking today in the morning is, why Kerala police is still soft on the bishop? 85 days have been given to him, 85 days to destroy evidence, to in fact influence others, and nothing has happened so far. Today he will be in fact questioned, hopefully rigorously. Question number four that we are asking on the burning question, why is the church backing the rape accused? It's baffling that there is a congregation, the Missionaries of Jesus, which is in fact attacking the victim. The church is silent on that. Why hasn't the church come out in support of the victim and at least sack him, suspend him till the time the investigations are on? Question number five that we are asking on the burning question today is, why are the netas silent on the rape accused in this case? Nobody, neither from the government in Kerala, nor from the Congress party, the opposition, is willing to speak, is willing to support the victim. To discuss these questions, I have, in fact, a guest on the show with me. Let me introduce the guests who are joining us in the morning. Sunit Chopra, leader of the CPIM, is joining us on the broadcast. Parmila Nasirgi, a well-known women rights activist, is with us early this morning. Kevin Matthew is also joining us. He's a social critique and joint secretary, Kerala Christian Forum. I want to start by asking you, Kevin, the fact that despite this offer that I want to step down, isn't it, a little embarrassing that for the last 85 days, the church has not made its position clear as far as this case is concerned? Why wait for Vatican? Shouldn't this be a procedure that till the time an investigation of such a serious nature is going on, the bishop should be asked to step away? All right, we seem to have lost that line with Kevin. We will try and reconnect with him. I want to go across to Parmila Nasirgi, who is with us on the broadcast. 85 days on, in a rape case of a man who is in a powerful position, the initial investigation of the police suggests that the crime did take place. That's a prima facie evidence that the superintendent of police, who is investigating the case in his report, had submitted to the court. Yet the Kerala police has not arrested this man. Does it inspire any confidence in the investigation, ma'am?
Definitely. See, any event for that matter, rape is a very serious offence. I do not know why he has not yet been arrested. Even if it was an ordinary case, they would have taken him to custody. They would have had the custodial interrogation. Look at here. He has filed an application for anticipatory bail. Bail has not been granted. There is no interim bail application also, and no order has been passed. It is evident that they can arrest him forthwith and they can interrogate him. See, the custodial interrogation in a rape case is a must. Not only he must be arrested today when he arrives in Kerala. Now, after that, he must be subjected to medical examination. Potency test has to be done. All these things must start. I can't really understand, otherwise all these evidence would be lost. Here is a case where it's a powerful person, church is behind it, government is behind it, police are lethargic, they are not taking immediate action, unlike in any other case. Something is happening.
Yes.
See, church and the person who is in the position of a bishop, he is in a religious position. So people expect him to be good. See, he must be a role model, and if he indulges in that, there must be special care taken, and he must be booked immediately.
Let me put that question to Sunit Chopra because you've raised a very important point that the government so far has been silent. Mr. Chopra, would you like to answer what Pramila ji is saying? Because the fact remains that we have not heard any senior leader or the minister from the government speak about this case. This has created a lot of outrage, sir. There are people, those who have been on hunger strike continuously, in fact, demanding justice for the nun.
Not only one minister. Sorry. You are giving wrong information. You are giving wrong information. It's not that no minister has spoken. E.P. Jayarajan, who's a senior member of the cabinet in Kerala, E.P. Jayarajan has spoken. The agriculture minister has spoken in favor of the nun. V.S. Achyutanandan has spoken in favor of the nun. We cannot force the trial. That is up to the judges and up to the court. We believe the church will take its position. They are free to do so. But as far as the government is concerned, there is to be no softness on this. And that is why, even when you were saying that he has not left Jalandhar and all, in fact, he was coming here under police. So please be careful.
Mr. Chopra, it's been 85 days, sir. It's been 85 days. Don't you think that this is unusually long time which has been given to an accused in a high-profile case in which he is in a position of power? He has not yet been, there has been no custodial interrogation that has taken place. Don't you believe, sir, this doesn't inspire too much confidence in the investigation? That's not up to the court, sir. That's up to the police, which comes under the Home Minister of the state of Kerala.
The investigating authority, that is the Kerala police, has been praised by the court that even in a case that is so old, they have done a good job. And that is why the discrepancies are there, and they will deal with them. Last time he was interviewed for 9 hours, and I can expect the same this time, and possibly whatever the court decides.
Mr. Chopra, you have also seen, as a politician, many cases coming to you. But do you, I once again reiterate the fact that I'm asking you, sir. I'm not raising any aspersions on the investigation. I am only talking to you about the delay that has taken place for the last 85 days since the time this FIR was registered against the bishop. The initial report which we have in our possession, which has been submitted in the court as well, suggests the superintendent of police who's investigating says, prima facie, there is a case of rape which is made out against the bishop. Why is a man of his stretcher still out, not arrested? That's the primary question, sir.
That you have to ask the Kerala police and the court. This is the same court that tortured Hadia for so long. So please don't expect unusual things to happen. The kind of
well, expecting
we have,
a bishop who has been accused of rape, a man in a powerful position, to be arrested, if that, according to your definition,
Ram
is unusual,
Rahim,
I mean, I don't know what else
arrested,
to say on that. Let me get in Kevin Matthew Sunny on this at this point of time. Kevin, the question that I asked you before, please, and I started with that, is why would the church not suspend him, ask him to step aside till the time the investigation in such a big case is in fact on? Why is that the bishop, despite now saying after the outrage that I will step down, don't you think for a fair investigation, and that happens in every case, in a case of a politician as well, this demand is made, shouldn't he have stepped down? But church not asking him to do so, do you think that inspires confidence in the people, those who are closely watching this case?
Ankit, the bishop stays in his position or not, it doesn't act like the investigation in any way. See, the investigation is happening, it is being done by the police, and the bishop has no authority, the church has no authority over there. And,
Kevin, don't you find your argument laughable? Because you're saying that he's in no position to of any interference. He's coming out, and the missionaries of Jesus is coming out after statement after statement. They have put out the picture with the nun as well. This is trying to influence not only the public opinion but also the investigation. In his anticipatory bail plea, the only defense that he has made is to malign the nun. For a person of this stature, do you feel that the church has done enough? Come on, Kevin. You have to rise above what you're seeing right now. There are people, those who are on hunger strike, asking for the same. They are asking for him to be removed and his arrest.
See, Ankit, one question is, if he is arrested by a local police body, calls him a culpable, and if he's arrested, then that is one thing. See, at that point, if the judge doesn't ask him to step down, or if he's not removed from the post, that is another thing. But now that he's an accused and he has presented his side of the argument, and I believe the church is also waiting, the people from the church is also waiting for that to happen.
Well, I will then only say that the church is not only giving a long rope, but the church is firmly behind the bishop, not on the side of the nun. And that is absolutely shameful, because if he has been accused, if he's in that position, the least that the church could have done is to ask him to step down till the time the investigations are over. Nobody is saying that he is already a convict. He should have stepped down till the time the court decides one way or the other. That's the least that could have been expected of the church. They have been found wanting on this. I have to take a very quick break. I'm going to come back to this. His anticipatory bail is yet to be finalized by the court on 25th September, the next date of hearing, and we are still waiting for the Kerala police to investigate, question, and take this bishop Franco Mulakal in custody. Pramila Nasargi, you know, I want to come to you because you heard what Sunit Chopra was saying and also Kevin. Don't you think the least that the church could have done at this point of time, because he is a man who is in fact in a powerful position, and that he should have stepped away? He is in a position not only to influence the witnesses, and others, those who are part of the church, he's also in a position, and every step that he has taken is only to malign the victim while the investigation are still going on.
I agree with you. See, the first thing that the church should have done was immediately he should have been suspended, and they should have allowed the prosecution to prosecute him in a proper way. There is a difference between interrogation, custodial interrogation, and ordinary interrogation. Look at here in this case, the superintendent of police has already given a report stating there is a prima facie case. If there is a prima facie case, then immediately he should have been arrested and permission should have been taken to custodial interrogation, and he should have been interrogated. A person in custodial interrogation, what the evidence that he gives and in other case entirely differs. This person is standing in a position like a white collar criminal. He cannot be treated like an ordinary criminal. White collar criminals are different persons. They must be treated differently, and prosecution must have taken immediate action to arrest him forthwith, having the subject him to medical examination,
yes. Seizure
as a spot inspection, spot murder should have been done, all other things should have been, nothing has been done. Look at the irony. I think Mr. Kevin or the other person was telling, the two of the ministers have come in support. That does not mean the Home Minister has supported. And if they are supported, why the Home Minister keeping quiet? Why the investigation is keeping quiet?
Yes.
I can't really understand. If really the prosecution was interested, they should have taken him into custody, and then they should have subjected him to thorough investigation, which has not been done.
They are
allowing him and giving him a long rope to prevent the evidence.
Okay, Sunit Chopra. The fact also remains that, there have been people, those who have been protesting, continuously protesting, not one leader. Isn't there the part of the ruling dispensation, the government and the political parties also to show sympathy with those who have been protesting across Kerala? Doesn't this become a big political point for you as well? Or is it that you believe the dominance of the church over the Christian vote is so much that the both, and I'm not only holding you accountable, I'm holding the opposition accountable on that as well, that nobody wants to take on the church?
It's not a question of nobody wants to take on the court, the church. It's a question of what has happened and when it is happening. First of all, the bishop had 2 years to hide the evidence if he so wanted. And I'm sure he may have. But that is one aspect. The other aspect is Kerala was totally involved in the flood. And the central government made life impossible so that when foreign funds were coming from Malayalis, the Prime Minister said, we will not accept them. In all this chaos, you cannot expect the government to give up everything and follow a rape case. The police apparently, according to the information that I have, has done a good job. But the point is, there are certain differences that have to be ironed out in both the testimonies.
Mr. Chopra.
And that is why he is being brought to Kerala.
Mr. Chopra, but again, you know, I beg this again, the question then comes in, is this the usual procedure for every case, Mr. Chopra?
I will not answer that.
Mr. Chopra, calm down. First of all, calm down. Early morning, don't need to raise your blood pressure.
Yes.
Early morning, nobody likes to be shouted upon. I am trying to be civil with you, so should you be. Now, why don't you tell me, is this, Mr. Chopra, a normal circumstances, this
I'm
sort of a courtesy of
I'm
85 days? You don't want to answer, Mr. Chopra,
the speaker,
then there is no need for you to come onto my show. You will answer the question that I'm asking. It is not a monologue that you are allowed here, sir.
PC George has been charged. The point is, you have given wrong information, saying that the government did nothing. I had to tell you that so-and-so, so-and-so, so-and-so ministers have already spoken.
It doesn't matter whether those ministers have spoken after the outrage. It's been 85 days, and I will keep asking this question. What was the government doing? Why hasn't the chief minister spoken on this issue? Why hasn't he, in fact, asked the church to ask this man to step down? This is the job of the head of the state. You can't put it under the carpet by saying we have done enough. 85 days, and this bishop is still out, sir.
What has happened? What has happened in Rewari? What happened with
You have no right to question what has happened in Rewari. We are doing that. It's been 7 days, and Khattar government is already facing the, in fact, the flag for that. And in comparison, you want to compare things? Is that what the left wants to do, CPI wants to do, compared to tragedies so that they can come out looking better?
You must compare, because it's in India that you're doing it. You're not in some West European country.
Amazing. Amazing this argument.
And the point is,
compare to crime so that your government comes out looking better. You should be shameful of this argument, sir. And even by that comparison, it's been 85 days, and the prime accused in this case has not even been taken into custody. So what have you been doing? What has the government of Kerala been doing? In 85 days, you could not arrest one man, and you want to compare what is happening in other crime? Shameful argument, Mr. Chopra, early in the morning. Kevin, I want to come to you, and I want to read out what the primary report of the superintendent of the police, who has in fact submitted in front of the court. This is the primary report of his investigation. During the course of the investigation so far conducted and the available evidences collected, it is revealed that the accused Bishop Franco committed unnatural offense and committed rape repeatedly on different dates from 23rd 9/2016 to 5/05/2018 against the will and consent of the nun, and by abusing, and this is important for you, and by abusing his dominance over her as Bishop of Jalandhar and confining her in a guest house, room number 20, and they have given the address of the guest house. Kevin, please tell me, is there any way to in fact stand behind this man till the time the investigations are concluded? And that is why I'm again asking you, and I'm hoping that you will have a better answer for me. As a Christian, as an individual, forget about the religion, as an individual, won't you want him to step down from where he is so that an investigation, free and fair investigation, can take place? The primary report of the police says that he used his dominance over the nun. Don't you think he can utilize this till the time he is in that position?
Ankit, three points. First thing about the primary report of the police. The same police has been investigating, and if they have not arrested him till 85th day, I believe they have reasons for that. And see, for as a person, as an individual, and as a part of a religion and everything, see, all I want is justice to be served. That's the first part of the question. Now, coming to the second part about the bishop stepping down, or that part. I think the church has taken a position. See, they have a right to take a position, and they have taken a position of equal distance. They have
equal
not come
distance?
Out in support of
Kevin. This is not somebody deciding a property dispute. This is being decision being taken on a woman who has been repeatedly raped by a man who is in a superior position. And Kevin, this whataboutry that you try and present, that they have reasonable doubts. There are no reasonable doubts in a rape case till the time the, and you need to understand, the jurisprudence of this country says in a rape case, the onus is on the accused to prove himself that he's not guilty, not the other way around. And all that we see, people like you, sensible people like you, also coming out and defending the police or saying that there are enough ground, there has to be equal distance. These cases don't have an equal distance, Kevin.
Ankit, I'm saying I don't know the reasons behind. See, if
but Kevin, don't you think he should step down? How can the church take an equal distance in a case in which people are protesting a nun has been raped?
See, the church, rather than the equal distance, I re-articulated, the church has chosen a path of inaction, which is, it's a viewpoint.
I am sorry, the church has taken the side of the bishop. by not asking him to step down from his position. Church, even if they wanted to take an equal distance, they would have said that the bishop to step down till the time the investigation are over. This argument doesn't hold any water, Kevin. There is no equal distance. They are right now supporting the bishop, and that is very, very much visible as far as this entire congregation goes. They are allowing missionaries of Jesus to come out and malign the nun. Is that equidistance?
See, one congregation, one individual is not the church.
Why not? Why shouldn't the church? Why shouldn't the church speak against that? Why shouldn't the church speak against the congregation, which is now taking side of the bishop, which is maligning the nun?
The church has not spoken at all. And that's
the problem, Kevin. And people, sensible people like you, keep defending it in the name of faith, in the name of that church. You have to question, Kevin.
If sensible people don't question what is going on in their religion,
we are doomed, Kevin.
There's no matter of faith coming in here. This is not a question of faith.
I'm sorry, I don't buy this argument of equidistance. The church should have spoken. The church should have taken a stand in which they should have told that this man to step down till the time the investigations are over. Church has not spoken a single word about a nun being maligned, salaciously being maligned by those who are supporting this bishop. And you are in fact expecting people to believe the church is equidistant. Church is not taking a position. Well, the church is clearly putting its weight behind this powerful bishop. And that is why it becomes more necessary, Carmilla, for this man to step away from any position, from any authority. Don't you think so, that these arguments are absolutely hollow of the church, standing at equidistance from Nasargi?
Ankit, see, you have to understand that, see, both the bishop and the nun, both of them are
I want to put that question to Parmila, because possibly she will understand, the plight of a woman better, possibly much better than even the church. Ms. Nasargi, go ahead. All right, we seem to have lost that line with Premier Nasargi, but the fact remains in the end, and that is exactly what we have been saying. It's what equidistant when you don't ask the man in a powerful position who can influence the witnesses, who can influence others, those who are involved in this case, to step down. This is not the time to be equidistant, and by not speaking against the congregation and the bishop who are maligning the nun, you are not standing in between. You are actually standing much more closer to the bishop than to the victim. I am only hoping that today would be a turning point in this case. Custodial interrogation of the bishop is necessary, and that is what we are going to see when the Kerala police speaks to this accused. Thank you so much, Kevin, Sunit Chopra and Parmila Nasargi, for joining me on the broadcast early this morning on The Burning Question and discuss this issue. And we will keep a very close eye, because the bishop is in Kerala. Today he will be questioned by the police. We'll be getting you more updates from that. Slipping into a very short break.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.